Today I'm going to show you how I made this hero animation for my website. It's cool, the pieces of the logo come out and make a sort of a link hover effect. This was done using the GSAP FLIP plugin, so I'm going to be going over mostly custom code. First half of the video, we'll talk about the page setup. Second half of the video, we'll walk through the code. As always, in the description below, I will have timestamps so you can skip to whatever chapter you're interested in. And then also, I will have a link to my Webflow resources library where you can get the code. All right, let's go ahead and have a look at the project here. So I've got a basic setup in client first, and my main thing is this home component here. The logo is actually all done in HTML and CSS. To make this work, you're going to have to make sure your logo like is not a PNG or whatever. I'm sure you could do something, but you couldn't do this with it. Let's see. And then I have, so let's just collapse this. I have home component. This is just a vertical grid. And that's got the logo grid, the header, and then the menu. The logo grid is made up of, let's see here. It's got 5 columns and 2 rows. The columns are set to auto. The width is controlled by each of these blocks, W block. You see it has a width and height of 2 rem. It's also set to absolute. And because of that, I had to put in this backing block, which is set to relative. So it actually is within the document and takes up space. So the reason I did this was that as I'm moving these blocks up and down, if these are not set to absolute, then I find like I get shifting in the grid up here. So making something absolute and then just having like a placeholder is all that the purpose that this is serving. These also, let's see, if I remove this is red, that's just controlling the color. I made them a little bit gray so you can see. Other than that, they have a scale of 1.1. That's just to make them a little bit bigger, so there's less space between them, and then a rotation of 45 degrees. And then each one has its own combo class, is orange, is gold, is purple, is blue. So I'll put the is red back on there. And the next interesting item, well, before we move on, over in the settings here, I have a selector in the custom attributes. Down at home, these are just link blocks with text behind them. Nothing too special about the link blocks position relative because we're going to put an absolute div in there. I'll show you this more later. And then just some other styling, some text inside. And then these also have a custom attribute that we can select by. I think that's everything I want to show you here. We'll be back to show you one or two more things. Oh, down here I have a control hide where I have WB block with a combo class of hover on it. This is going to come into play later. I just put this down in there because if we don't have hover and then we say we want to do a styles cleanup, then it's going to find that combo class of hover not on anything. So I want to put that on something so that if I go to clean up my project, I don't lose that. Okay, let's walk through the code. The first thing we're going to do, I'm going to go ahead and save this. And here's where we're published. Go ahead and publish this just to make sure if I did make any changes, we're all good to go. We should see that this isn't working. Yep. So first thing I've got here is I want to add an event listener to when all of the content on the DOM is loaded. And then I'm going to define a function called init that's going to run once the DOM content loaded event is done. And the first thing we'll do is we will register the GSAP plugin flip. And so I've got the GSAP installation here. We'll go to the GSAP 3 install helper and make sure to check this box flip. Copy and paste these into your Webflow project, which I have over here in home. Right here, and then in my code sandbox file, I'm loading with this script tag right here. So you can see GSAP, that's core, flip, and then the code sandbox file here. Close that down, back to the code. All right, logo grid. We're going to use document.query selector, and I'm just using the class here, home underscore logo grid. So what that's doing is that's getting a reference to home underscore logo grid. I need the logo blocks. I'm using query selector all for that and using that custom attribute that I showed you for each logo block. So I would expect to get a what's called a node list, very similar to an array of all the logo blocks that are on the page. So all 5 of these. And then I also need the link blocks, and those again are selected via their custom attribute, and so I expect to get 5 link blocks as well. All right, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to link through each of those link blocks, and I'm going to apply a listener. I'm going to listen for the hover event when the user is hovered over them. And the for each function, it takes a, you'll see if I hover over it, it says for each takes a callback function and it has a value. And you also get the index here, which is going to come into play because we're communicating between this logo blocks array and this link blocks array. And the first thing we're going to do is on each individual link block, we're going to add an event listener of mouse enter. This is the same as hover. And then we're going to define a function to execute when that happens. So let's see if we hover over add event listener. So it takes a type, which is we're passing that string mouse enter, and then the callback function. Okay. And first thing we'll do is we'll just console log that we're hovering. And here I'm accessing the link block. We'll get the first child and we'll get its text content. And I will return what index that is. So I'll go ahead and save that just to kind of show you what's going on. I'm going to refresh this page and open the JavaScript, the Chrome DevTools here. And as I hover, you see hovering over no-code tools with index 0, components with index 1, blog index 2. Okay, so we're accessing things correctly here. Keep stepping through the code. Now what we're going to do is we want to get the corresponding logo block that's associated with that index. So what that's saying here is when I get no code tools with index of 0, I want to get this logo block with index of 0. This will have index 1, 2, 3, and 4. So they all map to the link blocks that they're going to go to. Now I'm saying if I don't get a logo block, I want to return. The main thing here is that say you coded this and you had 6 links or something and only 5 logo blocks, then you don't want to start accessing things that will return null values because then you'll get errors in your console. So it's just protecting our code. And then the first thing we're going to do is we're going to find state for flip. And when you're doing a flip animation, there's kind of 3 main steps. I have the flip documentation open here. And let's see, flip plugin lets you seamlessly transition between 2 states, even if there are sweeping changes to the structure of the DOM that would normally cause elements to jump. So it's just saying that it's going to do a lot of heavy lifting for you. But if you scroll down after the examples on usage, they say, okay, there's typically 3 states to a flip animation. First, you're going to get the current state. Second, you're going to make state changes. And 3, you're going to call and the animation to happen. So if we go back to our code, we are storing the state for the logo block because that's what we're going to move. So that's stored in this variable called state, and we're letting flip handle all of that for us. And the first thing we want to do is we want to append that logo block to the link block. So we're physically moving. I'm going to save this, but I'm going to show you what we're doing is we're physically moving this WB block down here. Okay? So that's down there now. And I'll go ahead and save this and refresh here, and you can see we should get exactly that result. Yep. So everything's going back. And we don't have a mouse leave function, so everything's just stuck. But that's fine. The next thing we want to do is we want to actually change how the logo block is looking. So we're going to toggle this class called hover. And I'll show you that that class of hover is defined down in this WB block is hover. So if I take this one that we moved down here, let's say, okay, it's in the position we want it to be in the DOM, but now we want to change how it's styled. Don't put hover here. You'll see Webflow is telling us, oh, you want to create a new combo class. We don't want to create a new combo class, but we want a combo class that affects all the WB blocks, but not based on the selector here is red. So I'll just delete that for now. And if I type hover, you'll see now it's got this. It's taken up the whole space here. It's got width and height of 100%. It's absolute and set to take up the whole container. And then down here, it's got opacity 50%. The scale is the same, but we set the rotation back to 0. Remember, it was at 45 earlier. Okay, so we've triggered this toggle of hover as well. And I save that, and let's see how it looks now. Refresh. Okay, we're getting a lot closer to what we want. The main thing is we want to actually animate this thing, right? So that's just going to be this GSAP flip.from. And we're going to have it take 0.5 seconds, and we'll have an easing function of expo.out. And if I save this, now we should see a pretty good... We're almost there, right? It's definitely a little bit wonky. Like, we don't have a good hover out, and the rotation's not happening. So something that GSAP allows us to do with the flip plugin is to define properties. And I'm going to just tell it specifically what I animate because it only recognizes a couple properties by default. So I'm defining this props object up here, and I want to pass transform because that's, I was noticing rotation was off, and transform is defined by, or rotation is defined by the transform. And then I'm also changing the width and the height. Those are the big things that I want to animate. So if I save this and I refresh, let's see what we get now. Much better. Look at that. Really, really smooth and slick, and GSAP's just doing it all for us. Now, we want to also do the, on hover out, we want to restore it to its original state. So we'd do almost the exact same thing as we did up here, but now we're changing this from mouse enter, we're changing this to mouse leave. Let's see what all the differences are. So logo block is the same, get state is the same. Now, the main thing we're doing is we're toggling that hover class again, but rather than appending this to the logo block, we're going to append it back to logo grid. Remember, logo grid is this thing right here. So we want to put it back to where it was. And these are manually assigned to their spot in the grid so that they know where to go. That makes things quite a bit nicer. Don't mess with auto grid on this. That might get things jumbled up. And then we're running the animation again. So let's go ahead and save and refresh. And if I hover and I hover out, now we've got the animation like we do. Now something I want to show you is if I refresh, but I'm hovering over the link at the time of refresh, there's, it gets buggy, right? And I think what's going on here is that the hover, this event for hover that we've done is happening before flip can save the state. So one quick little way to get around that is to define a tracker variable called hasEntered. We'll set it to false. And we'll set it to true once it, we'll set this has entered to true once we do have a hover in. And on the mouse leave, so the mouse leave, what was happening before is the mouse leave was triggering before we had ever triggered hover or mouse enter. So this makes sure that, that we ensures that we trigger mouse enter before we trigger mouse leave. So if has entered is false, then we return. And at the end of mouse leave, we set it to false. So let's go ahead and save that now. And I'll refresh with my mouse hovering over this. And now everything's working. Looks great. Okay, that's wrapped it up. If you liked this, please like and subscribe. If you're making stuff with GSAP, let me see it. Don't forget to check out my free Webflow resources. Lots of good stuff in there. And until next time, I'll chat with you later. All right, bye.